Hello friends! In this video, we will review a new device from the Aqara Smart Home ecosystem, an actuator designed for opening and closing ball valves. Actuators, unlike ready-made solutions such as controlled valves, do not require modifications to the existing pipe system, which significantly simplifies installation and improves reliability. I will leave links in the description below the video to my previous reviews of both actuators and valves. The main focus of this review is a device with several unique features. First and foremost, it can operate not only with lever-operated valves, but also with butterfly-type valves. Another notable feature is its autonomous operation using batteries, eliminating the need to lay wires for power supply. More details on everything will follow, but for now, as always, I kindly ask you to like this video so that it can reach more people interested in smart home topics, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. Type of device, ball valve actuator. Model, Aqara T1. Interface, zigbee 3.0. Power source, 4 AA batteries. Torque, less than or equal to 3.6 Nm. Opening slash closing time, 5 to 20 seconds. Operating temperature, minus 10 degrees Celsius, 50 degrees Celsius. Operating humidity, 0 to 95%, non-condensing. Compatible valves, lever, butterfly. Maximum pipe diameter for installation. Depends on the mounting system, DN20 or DN25. Dimensions, 93 by 72 by 84 millimeters. The device is supplied in the manufacturer's characteristic white and blue box, designed for devices intended for the domestic Chinese market. There is also a model for the global market. On the back of the box, the model number and technical specifications are listed, as I've already mentioned. For the global market, the actuator is released under the model number VC-X01D. The package includes the main unit with the motor and control board, essentially the actuator itself, a set of mounting hardware, batteries, and a small instruction manual. There are two mounting kits for pipes. One is designed for pipes with a diameter of up to 3/4 inch, DN20, and the other is for pipes up to 1 inch, DN25. Additionally, there is an assembled lever for controlling valves with butterfly-type handles. 4 AA batteries are included. They are from a Chinese brand unknown to me. For now, the device will work with these batteries. Since this model is intended for the domestic market, the instructions are only available in Chinese. Moreover, the manual is quite limited. For instance, it only shows the installation process for valves with a lever handle. I will provide a link to a more detailed manual in English in the description below the video. The actuator's body is made of dense white plastic. Most of the explanatory labels are written in Chinese characters. On the top, there are activity indicators, reset buttons, and a manual motor control button. The large button labeled push is used to unlock the valve lever. By default, the device is assembled in a configuration for controlling lever-operated valves, similar to its counterparts, for instance, from the Tuya ecosystem. You can find links to these reviews in the video description. On one of the sides, there is a QR code for quick connection. However, it is not mandatory. During all my tests, I didn't need to use it even once. Under the battery compartment lid, there are slots for 4 AA batteries. Disassembling the device is quite simple. The casing lid is held by 4 screws. Inside, you will find the control board and at the bottom, the motor. The motor operates through a gearbox. The entire assembly is fixed to the casing with 4 screws as well. I did not disassemble the gearbox. Most likely, I wouldn't be able to restore it to working condition. However, everything else accessible is made of metal. No plastic gears, everything is reliable. A small gear on the gearbox shaft is connected to a gear mechanism linked to the lever shaft. This is how the valve opens and closes. When the push button is pressed, the connection disengages and the lever can be turned manually. After installing the batteries, the valve enters pairing mode. The same happens after being removed from the gateway. Compatibility testing starts with the basic Aqara home management system for the mainland China region. Here, I have an Aqara M2 gateway, which is, by the way, the global version with the latest firmware. The actuator in pairing mode was automatically detected, so all I had to do was select it and wait for the connection process to complete. the new device appeared in the list of devices. The plugin is quite simple. In terms of logic, the control is similar to a relay with two states, on or off. This is how the actuator operates. I'll show it in action on valves a bit later. In the plugin, you can enable direct association with leak sensors. When triggered, the actuator will immediately shut off the water. Unfortunately, I don't have suitable sensors here. They are all integrated into Home Assistant. A timer allows you to set a time from 1 minute to a day. After this, the actuator will switch to the opposite state from its current one. In the general settings, everything is standard: card, device name and location, firmware version check, signal level, automation list, and removal from the system. In automations, the actuator can be used in the if section, where two events are available, on or off. For example, upon deactivation, shutting off, you can send a notification. There are also two conditions, on or off, which can be used with other events. In the then section, there are three actions, turn on, turn off, and toggle the state. These are similar to switches, sockets, and relays. For instance, you can create a scenario that weakly opens and closes the valve to prevent it from seizing. The installation process starts with the mounts designed for pipes up to 3/4 inch in diameter, DN20, and a lever-operated valve. A key point is the availability of free space for both the mounting and the actuator block itself. Often, the installation is so tight that there is simply not enough physical space. In this case, I managed to install the actuator, but the access panel covering this area could no longer be closed. Let me clarify, this is just a demonstration of the operation. I'm not planning to use the actuator here, so I didn't secure it tightly. For permanent use, it's necessary to adjust it better to the pipe and the valve. Now let's check valves with butterfly handles. Here, additional steps are required. First, as per the instructions, assemble the lever, which consists of three parts screwed together. Next, remove the lever installed by default, as it is not needed for this type of valve. The motor shaft is threaded. Currently, nothing is installed on it. First, install the nut that came with the butterfly valve lever. Then, attach the lever itself and secure it with the same fastener that was previously used. Here, I used a different mount suitable for pipes up to 1 inch in diameter. This is how it operates. Final adjustments are made using the side screws on the lever. The Aqara M2 gateway, to which the actuator is now connected, works as a bridge with Apple HomeKit. The device appears as a switch in HomeKit. Battery level is also displayed in the properties. Control is basic, turning it on and off, including through a voice assistant. This gateway also supports the Matter protocol, allowing direct integration with other systems, including Home Assistant. Several entities are available: switch on AOF, device identification, battery level, and even battery voltage. Opening and closing control works correctly and quickly. Data exchange occurs locally, without using the cloud. Pressing the identification button triggers the LED to blink, helping to identify the needed device among several identical ones. I've shown everything I could get from the Aqara M2 gateway. Now let's see if the Chinese version of the actuator works in the European region. Here, I have an Aqara E1 gateway updated to the latest version. The actuator connected without issues, which was expected, as a global version exists. This means information about the device is available on Aqara Home's European servers. Functionality is identical to what we just reviewed. If you use Aqara Home in the European region, the Chinese actuator model is suitable for you. Automations also work. Two events and two conditions in the if section and turn on, turn off, and toggle the state in the then section. Let's check if Mi Home users can use this device. Here, I have the China region selected and the Xiaomi Gateway 3 updated to the latest version. However, the device is not supported here. Physically, the gateway connects to it, but the problem is that the Mi Home servers do not have data about this device. Since it's not supported even in the China region, there's no point in testing it in the European region. Now let's move on to the Sunoff iHost controller, which serves as a local smart home control hub with a built-in Zigbee coordinator. The current version at the time of testing is 2.4.0. The actuator connected successfully, although the corresponding image and name did not appear. Let's check if it can be used. On the device tile, a switch icon is displayed. Interestingly, in alternative systems, the battery level shows as 50%, even though the batteries are new. Earlier, we saw that the level was 100%. The control operates like a regular switch. There is a status toggle and standard options for this type of device. Control works correctly. Feedback, when the actuator is manually operated, is also updated. The fact that it's displayed as a switch doesn't matter. General device information includes the manufacturer, identifier, and model name. There are no additional settings. Standard options include a scheduler where you can set the time and days of the week for the actuator to automatically open and close the valve. This option is similar to the timer in the native app. You set the time after which the actuator will switch to the opposite state. There's also a cyclic timer where you specify the operation time in a given position. For example, this could be used to automate irrigation. The valve will open at a set time for a certain period. Let's check how the actuator can be used in automations. This is the if section. As a trigger for automation, you can use the transition to the on state, open, or the off state, closed, and in the then section for actions. Here, besides turning on or off, or more precisely, opening or closing, there is also an option to toggle the state to the opposite. Sunoff iHost supports the Matter protocol in both directions. This means it can connect to smart home devices that support this protocol, and the controller itself can be passed as a bridge. In my case, it's connected to Google Home. The actuator appeared in Google Home, which was expected. We've already seen the Matter connection through the Aqara M2 gateway and Home Assistant. Here, valve opening and closing control is also supported. Let's return to Home Assistant, but this time we'll use alternative connection methods and Zigbee coordinators, starting with the native ZHA integration. The device was detected and connected. Several entities appeared. Let's examine them in more detail. There's a state switch, firmware version, and battery level, which also shows 50%. I'm not sure if this is accurate, as the batteries are new, but it might be a feature of how this device works. There's also an identification button. Control works correctly and quickly. The same goes for feedback during manual operation. The status and the system updates immediately after the state changes. For thoroughness, I tested the identification button. It also works, causing the activity LED to blink. Lastly, let's check operation with Zigbee 2MQTT. The current system version at the time of testing is 1.42.0. Native support is available. The device was correctly identified, although the model number matches the global version. There are no functional differences between them. Additionally, the actuator is a battery-powered end device, which makes sense. On the device page, there's a state switch, battery level, also displayed as 50%, and signal quality. Everything works correctly, both sending commands from the system to the device and updating the status during manual opening or closing. These entities, along with the firmware version, also appear in Home Assistant through the MQTT integration. It's the same as in ZHA, except for the identification button. In conclusion, this new product from Aqara can indeed work with valves that have either a lever or a butterfly handle. This is the first actuator I know of with such a capability, as all others work only with levers. Battery power eliminates the hassle of running power lines and addressing backup power solutions. You only need to monitor the charge level. By the way, it's still unclear why the battery level is displayed as 50%. I'll keep observing. An important point to consider before purchasing is whether there's enough space for mounting and if its rather bulky block will fit. Overall, the device turned out to be very interesting. It is supported in both the Chinese and global regions of Aqara Home, integrates into Apple HomeKit and Google Home, and works with Sunoff iHost and Home Assistant through ZHA and Zigbee 2 MQTT. That's all for now. I hope the video was useful and interesting to you. I would appreciate your likes, they help promote it on YouTube. In the description below the video, I'll leave links to stores where you can order this gadget, as well as to my Telegram channels and social networks, and groups for discussing smart home topics. Join us, it'll be interesting. Thank you for your attention, and see you next time. Peace to everyone.